Magnitude comparator is also called magnitude digital or binary comparator. It compares and indicates if the binary number P is equal to or greater than or less than the other binary number Q. We want to compare two binary numbers P and Q and getting which number is greater. So we need two numbers as inputs and three outputs, one for the quality, one if P is greater than, and the other if P is less than Q. So let's start comparing one bit. This is the truth table of one bit comparator. We want the output equal 1 if the inputs are equal, so if they are both 1 or both 0. We want the output P greater than Q if P is 1 and Q is 0, and P less than Q if P is 0 and Q is 1. For the quality, we can use a XNOR gate. This is indeed the truth table of the XNOR in which we have the output at 1 only when the input bits are equal. We can write the relation in this way. For P greater than Q, we need the output at 1 only when P is 1 and Q is 0, so we can build such circuit with an AND gate and an inverter. For the P less than Q case, we need P0 and Q1, and this can be achieved always with an AND gate and an inverter. So, this is the cell of 1-bit comparator. If, for example, both the inputs are at 1, we get 1 on the output of the XNOR gate, indicating that the two inputs are equal. Moreover, we get a 0 on the output of the two inverters, so the output of the two AND gates are at 0. In this way, we have a 1 only in the equal bit, as we wanted. If we now put a 0 in the Q input, then on the output of the XNOR gate, we get a 0, because the two inputs are different, and on the output of the inverter, there is now a 1, changing the output of the AND gate at 1. So, as we wanted, only one of the output is at 1, and the output at 1 indicates the quality or the magnitude of a number in comparison with the other. Now, we want to build an unsigned 4-bit comparator. Let's see how we can do. First, in order to have the two numbers equal, this relation must be true. So, each bit of a number must be equal to the corresponding bit of the other number. We can write this requirement in this way. So, we put in bitwise XNOR the two numbers and we do the product of the result through an AND gate. In this way, if all the XNOR outputs are at 1 at the same time, then the final output is at 1 and the two numbers are equal. Now, let's see how to build a circuit to detect if a number is greater than the other. It is convenient to start the analysis from the most significant bit P3 and Q3. If P3 is greater than Q3, then the number P is greater than Q, and we don't need to check anything else. For example, if P3 is 1 and Q3 is 0, then PS is greater than QS, even if all the other bits of QS are at 1 and the other bits of PS are at 0. So the first condition for P greater than Q is this one here. But we have other condition in which P is greater than Q, so we add an OR to our statement. The second condition occurs if P2 is greater than Q2, and of course the most significant bits are equal. So, if P2 is 1 and Q2 is 0 and P3 is equal to Q3, we neglect the less significant bits. For example, if P is 12 and Q is 11, we are in the second condition. The third condition is if P1 is 1 and Q1 is 0 and all the more significant bits are equal. The fourth condition implies that P0 is 1 and Q0 is 0 and all the more significant bits are equal. These statements can be expressed in this other way. We see here the first condition where the product corresponds to the AND gate and the plus sign corresponding to the OR gate here. In the second term, we see the XNOR of P3 and Q3 because we want P3 equals Q3 and P2 1 and Q2 0, and so on. So this equation represents the circuit we should build. So now we have to build the circuit. It is not difficult because we know that where we see a plus sign, we use an OR gate. Where we see a product, we use an AND gate, and we recognize the XNOR. So here you see the circuit to detect P equals Q and P greater than Q. For example, the first condition is met if P3 is 1 and Q3 is 0. In this case, the output of the XNOR is 0 because the inputs are different, so the AND gate 2 is at 0. If Q3 is 0, this inverter is at 1, so the AND gate is at 1 and the output of the OR is at 1, detecting that P is greater than Q. Let's see the second condition. In this case, P2 is 1 and Q2 is 0, and P3 is equal to Q3, in our case 0. So the XNOR of the most significant bit is 1, but the XNOR of Q2 and P2 is 0, so that the final AND gate is 0, stating that the two numbers are not equal. Being P3 is 0, the output of the AND is 0 as well, but the second AND with the 3 input is at 1, generating the 1 on the output of the OR. The second AND is the product of P2, Q2 bar and XNOR of the most significant bit, so it has all the 3 inputs at 1. It is easy to see that this circuit implements all the 4 conditions to have P greater than Q. Similarly, the statements for getting the expression for PS less than QS are these, which can be written in this way. There is just an inversion in the P's bits which we want to be 0, and the corresponding Q bits which we want to be 1, so the circuit is very similar to the other portion. Here you see the wall of circuit. Note that for comparing two 4-bit numbers, we need AND gates up to 5-bit inputs and OR gates up to 4-bit inputs. So generalizing with 10-bit numbers, we need gates up to N plus 1 inputs. Gates with a lot of inputs need area and are slow, so in general it is better cascading some 4-bit comparators. This is the IC7485, which is a 4-bit comparator similar to that seen before. The difference here is that this comparator has 3 extra inputs to receive the situation of the previous bit comparison. For example, a 8-bit comparator is obtained connecting the two blocks in this way. You see, the second comparator takes the previous situation from the first comparator. In the first comparator, you need to put high the equal bits and low the other two bits. These 3 extra inputs allow several comparators to cascade for comparison of any number of bits. Please leave me a comment, let me know if you liked this video. Make sure you put a thumb up, click the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel.